President Marcos endorses an international labor organization agreement aimed at ending workplace harassment to the Senate for ratification. Senate minority make that majority leader Joel Villanueva lauds the move and vows the Senate's concurrence to the global framework. He believes this would help overseas Filipino workers amid increasing violence against them. The business process outsourcing sector also welcomes the development. Industry group Be Glad says this would safeguard the rights of workers in the sector whom it believes are prone to workplace harassment. The Philippine Poll Body calls off a special election meant to fill the seat of expelled Negros Oriental lawmaker Arnulfo Teves Jr. The House of Representatives ordered that move, citing Teves's continued absence after he was tagged as the mastermind in the murder of Negros Oriental Governor Roel De Gamo. For the COMELEC, the cancellation of the special polls will still be favorable for the government.
My personal view, a matter of ilang buwan na lang o almost one year na lang ang term of office na natitira. So hindi naman buong 3 years. And so iniisip na rin siguro ng Congress, why proceed with the election and we will have the election by 2025? Come to think of it, we're going to spend 75 million pesos just to conduct the special election in the district. And then here comes, 1 year after, here comes another election involving the same district. Yung 75 million na dapat nagagastusin namin for the special election of Negros, kukuhanin namin yun sa lahat ng mga na-save namin sa procurement and everything na dapat nalalaan namin sa ibang bagay because we do not have available budget. So at least, hindi na postpone, wala na, hindi natuloy ang election. Therefore, nakatipid ang gobyerno, ang pamahalan, ang tao ng 75 million pesos.
Meanwhile, the poll body issued a warning against winning bets in the recent village and youth council polls who failed to account for their campaign expenses.
Until November 29, yung submission ng SOSE natin. And until today, wala pa pong mga 15% man lang yung nagsasubmit ng SOSE sa buong bansa. And of course, some of the candidates will be waiting for the last day to submit the statement of contribution and expenditure. But this is a warning to all those who ran in the last election. If you ran in 2018 and you did not submit the SOSE, and at the same time, you ran in 2022 and again, you did not submit the SOSE, the Supreme Court said failure to submit SOSE in 2 consecutive elections will mean perpetual disqualification to hold office, whether elective or appointive.
A group of retired Philippine military officers denying any involvement in an alleged plot to oust President Marcos. Victoria Tula now joins us with details. Victoria, what more can you tell us?
That's correct, Carmina. A group of retired uniformed officers denied they are behind supposed destabilization plots against the Marcos administration. The September 21 reform movement or storm and the TN trio firmly said in a forum in Quezon City that they did not hatch any plans to overthrow the government. They also denied approaching and talking to armed forces of the Philippines Chief of Staff, General Romeo Bronner Jr., and recruiting anyone. Former Colonel Mar Santiago said they do not even know all of the members of their group that well. He theorizes that misinformation might have happened. The retired officials say what Storm and TN Trio are pursuing is clean elections and electoral reform, particularly in light of the alleged irregularities in the 2022 national and local elections. According to Department of Information and Communications Technology, former Acting Secretary Eliseo Villa Jr., who is part of both groups, one of the anomalies in the elections was the alleged early transmission of election returns from both counting machines to the Commission on Election server. He said this happened as early as 1 p.m. on May 9, 2022, when the transmission should have only started at 7 p.m. He also claimed again that the use of a single IP address of about 20,300 vote counting machines was very suspicious. Storm and TN Trio believe Smartmatic, the technology provider in the elections, is destabilizing the government. ABS-CBN is yet to get a side of Smartmatic. COMELEC spokesperson John Rick Claudianco, for his part, said that no election returns were transmitted before the close of precinct at 7 p.m. The poll body has also answered allegation on the single IP address and previously said that this was provided to them by the telecommunications company and they didn't have any more time to change it given time constraints. COMELEC also said before that even with the same IP address, election results matched with the election receipts.
Philippine companies should double down on data protection measures. Cybersecurity firm Fortinet Philippines made this call after it found the country experienced millions of cyber attacks daily in the second quarter of this year alone. It warns that figure could still rise as the Philippines continues to lag behind its neighboring countries in terms of cybersecurity.
In the Philippines, what happened is during the pandemic, when everybody is rushing into the digitalization, right? Mm-hmm. So what happened is because there's a rush going into the digital space, they kind of put the security aspect of it on the side, mm-hmm. right? So I want to go to the digital space first. Security is an afterthought. Yeah. Whereas our neighboring Asian countries has already been in the digital transformation. They already learned their lessons on that. That's why I could safely say that the Philippines is really up there when it comes as a target.
Several government entities fell victim to hackers earlier this year, with the attack on state insurer PhilHealth affecting 13 million of its members. Meralco customers should brace for higher power bills this month. The utility giant announced a 23 centavo per kilowatt hour rate hike for November. This will translate to a 47 to 117 peso additional charge for regular household consumers. Meralco attributed the increase to the uptick of electricity prices at the spot market. The Philippine economy growing faster than expected in the third quarter, with government spending doing the heavy lifting this time around. Gross domestic product in the 3 months through September rose 5.9% from a year earlier. It's higher than most GDP projections, ranging from 4.3 to 4.9%. The development puts the Philippines back on track to post Southeast Asia's quickest expansion this year.
The year-on-year 5.9% GDP growth in the third quarter of 2023 is a marked improvement from the 4.3% growth in the second quarter. This performance makes our economy the fastest among the major emerging economies in Asia. Overall, government spending contributed to 2.1 percentage points, or 36%, of the observed 5.9% GDP growth. We commend the national government agencies and local government units for responding to the economic team's call to implement cuts-up expenditure plans. These actions address the contraction in government spending in the previous quarter. We hope to maintain this momentum.
The Philippine manufacturing sector seen as a sleeping giant that can boost the country's economic growth, Jackie Pascual reports.
The Philippine manufacturing industry needs some help from both government and the private sector. This was one of the assessments at a forum organized by the Philippine Economic Society and Strat-based ADR Institute. Former NEDA Secretary Ernesto Pernia said the country's manufacturing sector lags behind some regional neighbors because of many factors like low foreign direct investments and other internal concerns like corruption.
The current status quo makes it quite challenging for the Philippines being the laggard in to advance to its manufacturing sector. Enhancing the manufacturing sector, as our ASEAN peers have, requires ample foreign direct investments and, of course, domestic investments, and the capacity to export, which is facilitated, among others, by FDIs themselves.
Pernia cited the BSP data showing that FDI to the Philippines in 2022 amounted to $9.4 billion, much lower than Indonesia's $21.4 billion and Vietnam's $17.9 billion. This also affects exports, with the Philippines' exports to GDP ratio at 13.8%, lower than Vietnam's 104.2% and Malaysia's 63.3%. Other analysts agreed that the government must attract more investments in manufacturing by resolving issues on corruption and by upholding the sanctity of contracts.
It's turning out to be sluggish yet again. Really,
quite painful a challenge to do business here.
Rule of law, perception of corruption will always threaten any interest for investment. So side by side with encouraging an investment-led growth is really improvement with regards to greater transparency and accountability on public policy.
An engineer in the manufacturing industry disagreed with the speakers that the country's manufacturing sector is lagging behind Asian peers, saying the sector is in fact the biggest contributor to economic growth. He agreed, though, that more needs to be done to uplift the industry and for companies to put more value on products so it may be exported.
Coming from a non-economist, the Philippines is a manufacturing country. Pero if we're going to create productivity, we're going to be creating higher value products. Tapping smartly and sustainably our mining resources, namely gold, silver, copper, iron ore, and oil mining. But this implies not just extracting raw mining ores, but importantly, also processing, in effect, manufacturing them to maximize value added before exporting.
The Trade Department has partnered with USAID, Makati Business Club, the Advanced Manufacturing Workforce Development Alliance, or AMDEV, to help the manufacturing sector by upskilling or reskilling about 11,000 workers. USAID will fund $5.2 million, while the private sector will match it for the initial five-year program. AMDEV head Danilo Lachica, who is also president of the Semiconductor and Electronics Industries in the Philippines, said this program is much needed for workers to learn the so-called IR 4.0 or the Fourth Industrial Revolution skills such as AI or the Internet of Things.
IR 4.0 is because of IoT, because of sensors, because of connectivity, you have machines now talking to each other. Not all companies or industries are in the IR 4.0 regime. Yung iba nga nasa 2.0 or 3.0.
Improvement of employability, reduce unemployment and underemployment, and accelerate human capital development in the country, particularly in the manufacturing sector.
The said program is expected to beef up the manufacturing industry in the country and attract more foreign investments to the Philippines. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.